Mama, I'm coming home.
Okay. Oh, shit.
This is the room, right?
Ooh. Nice.
Oh.
Sorry. Like, talking out loud.
Hey, Michael, did you ever release that episode of Tomodachi World or whatever that was, like, with Bill Nye but slutty?
Not yet. I'll do it eventually. There's just, like, I always agree to do 20 things at once, so that's the problem. I will make it. I have all the recordings still. I want to make it still. I like doing those. Those are very, it's like storytelling, but it's really stupid storytelling.
Ow.
Okay, how do I... Okay, can I just... Do I put it in here? What am I supposed to do?
I don't know. Ask around, and no one answers, you know, hold them at gunpoint, like, tell me the answer, tell me the combination to the lock. Give me the money, you know.
Give me the emerald, or duh, I don't love you.
Give me the information that I seek.
I'm just trying to figure out what I need to do. And I keep getting killed by the guards, trying to figure it out before they kill me. Alright, let's try that again. Okay, so.
Quesaria, more like.
They call me Quesaria.
More like gonorrhea. I'm sure that's a parody song already. It's a very easy joke to make.
God fucking damn it.
I just ate something bad and now I have diarrhea, rhea, a, you know, like stuff like that.
Wow, great. You are a fucking lyrical genius.
I have, like, it's like any YouTuber can come up with that and make a music video out of it, you know? Such an easy joke to make.
When would be a good time to go into this place?
Imagine being a YouTuber.
Imagine believing in time.
Imagine being friends with,
Pokemon.
What's their name? Remember the couple that used to be together? They pulled pranks on each other.
I mean...
BF versus GF?
I vaguely know what you're talking about, but I also so very much don't care. Yeah. I don't care so much that, like, my brain is omitting it from my memory.
Yeah. Sounds like a you problem.
Yeah, it is, actually.
Mm. Yes, quite. As I sip my wine. My funny wine.
Yes, quite.
Yes, quite.
I'm just going to sip my Cherry 7 Up. Don't mind me.
Adequate.
Stop! You violated the law.
Discord, please.
Come on!
And now I have diarrhea, rhea, a.
It's like just, it is not explaining what to do.
It's not explaining how to become God.
But what is God?
The fuck?
Me.
Define God.
Me.
The stranger has forged a new letter for me. Now I have to go to the Imperial Legion compound in the Imperial City. I have to seal the letter using the official seal of the Legion commander. Is that this guy? What the fuck am I supposed to do? Fuck off! What do you mean, game clip recorded? You're not done.
Has it been an hour?
No. I don't. It's just being stupid. It's still recording. No, I started a new one.
Oh.
Okay, just fucking kill me. Jesus fucking Christ. It's telling me there's something I have to do in this room, but it's being so fucking vague on what that is. And it's
guess you gotta Google.
And the green arrow is showing me fucking, like, there's a green arrow whenever there's something in the room that you have to, like, either take or someone you have to talk to. But there's fucking nothing except a guard who's trying to kill me.
I can't wait for the comment section to be like, oh my god, this guy's such an idiot.
What comment section?
What comment section? Zach?
The very existent comment section. What do you mean?
Yes, all the comments that we get on these videos.
We don't even have Hail Hydra anymore.
That's true. Our whole comment section is fucking dead. One guy leaves. That's all we have.
Now what the fuck? I genuinely don't get that. This is fucking infuriating.
I feel like a better idea... You know what? Never mind. I was gonna say, like, a better idea instead of making beagles, but, like, why would I even think of that? But, like, I was gonna say, like, make Caillou.
No.
Yeah.
That's not better than Beakles.
I know, I was gonna say, and then I was like, no, it's not true.
It's pretty cringe, Zach.
Look at you using the word cringe. Look at this guy.
I'm like, this is fucking ridiculous. This is bullshit. What the fuck do you want me to do? This is fucking stupid.
Whoa.
I'm gonna open this fucking door and assume that the green arrow is supposed to be red. Because there's literally nothing else I can do in that room. Nope, it's telling me to go back downstairs, but there's still nothing here for me to do.
If Austin Stevenson commented on this video saying, great job, what would you think?
I would think he's being sarcastic, and I'd be like, fuck you, okay. I know what I have to do now. I'm gonna let him kill me though, because I wasted lockpicks in the process, I think.
What if Austin Stevenson DM'd you, saying he's always had feelings for you?
I would assume he's making fun of me.
Who is this guy?
What if
Brock from Stupid Mario Bros.
Oh, okay.
What if he said, I'm not joking, I'm being very serious. I want to...
I would absolutely indulge Austin in a conversation.
What if Austin Stevenson took off his mask and he was actually Dane this whole time?
I would say, how is that possible? You two were in videos together.
He would then respond with... He would then respond with, don't worry about it.
I would just stop talking to him.
You'd stop talking to Dane Kevin Cook?
Absolutely.
From youtube.com/UncleDane?
Without even thinking about it.
The hit YouTube channel, Uncle Dane.
I like
Dane.
Who's
also in this scenario, apparently in love with you.
Yeah. Posing as someone else to, yeah.
To get your attention?
Yes. Maybe he thought that would be an easy way to get into bed, I don't know.
Do you remember when Austin Stevenson liked one of the Beamless 100 Facebook page photos? And we didn't understand why?
Yeah.
Because it was just a really random photo.
of me.
Was it the one of you?
It was the one with me doing the troll face.
Yeah, there was a picture of Zach and Austin Stevenson like
holding up a toy gun with my name next to me. Just very weird.
Well, that didn't help me in there that I wasn't wearing armor when the guards were attacking me. That makes a little more sense why I was getting fucking killed immediately. Oh wow, this thing's stronger than I thought it was gonna be.
That's what she said.
I don't know how well that works there.
Like the penis is like really strong.
It's a drill.
Yeah, it goes to the gym.
You skip nut day? You're not flexing your
you
nuts?
You do push-ups, you sit-ups, and then the penis does its own ups, you know? It gets a workout.
You do wiener ups.
Wiener ups.
Yeah.
Sounds like a snack. Wiener ups. Get them while they're hot.
But in actuality, it's
a very perverted...
I have to go back to Anvil.
...that parents do not understand is a perverted snack, and they get it for their kids. It was made by pedophiles. Political thing goes to court, and it's like, yo, I didn't mean it. I thought I didn't know you were actually gonna get it for your kids. Then they get canceled
it was
for
a joke.
It. Joke. Don't cancel me, please. I have a family. I didn't mean it. My kids eat these. Wait, that's not what I meant to say. Oh God! And it becomes this whole other thing, you know. So yeah. Becomes crazy,
it's
yo.
Just a prank, bro.
Just a prank.
It was a prank. It was a prank, bro. Remember that Yoda clip?
No.
I think it was in a JonTron video. It was just like it was Zach Hadle voice in Yoda, and someone was just stomping on you, and he said, "Bro, it was a prank, bro."
Bro, it was a prank. It was a prank, bro.
I pay off my fine.
So that weather.
So that
about
weather,
it?
Huh?
How about it?
I feel like there's several parts getting cut out of tonight's recording.
Yeah, how about that weather?
I get it. When you improvise, you're gonna say stupid shit. There's like a whole 5 minutes being cut out
just
of what I recorded
it.
With.
Bleep it so then we don't have to like cut out anything. Just
no,
it.
I mean
you're
I
like, think
no,
like oh I said something stupid.
Slap out, so it doesn't even really matter all that much now, does it?
What?
I mean, there's a whole like. Bunch of silence here that you're gonna like slap out, so it doesn't even really matter all that much.
I did not edit the Sonic Adventure series like that much at all, but to be fair with that one, it was like five people in a call at a time, and there was non-stop like to discussion. There was like one part I cut out in an episode that I did with Chris, Austin, and Stuart, and the only reason I cut it out is because we started talking about someone someone who is a controversial figure, and I didn't have a problem with the conversation, but there is misinformation spread at one point, and I was just like, I'm not gonna have that in my video if I don't know what's true.
Was it about Xander, bro?
No. Me and Chris did a video. There's an episode of Tales from Storgette we did together. That's gonna we talk about Will Brower for like almost 30 minutes, but it's very positive. We like Will.
I would. Well, you know.
But
would
I'm
you?
Cutting. I kind of like low-key made fun of Will back in the day, and now I feel bad about it, and I like Will a lot.
It's not the topic of discussion.
I love Will. But Will's a great guy.
Would you?
But,
would you, Will?
I don't think
like
you
whole,
heard your question.
I don't care about his question.
I care about the question I'd like
you
to
just
answer.
You just keep asking me, would you have sex with this person? Would you have sex with this person? Would you have sex with this
Are
person?
Are you offended? Are you uncomfortable?
I'm unamused. I would with Will.
Thank you. That's all I want.
That's all I asked.
That's all I want. Thank God.
Just,
found the
just,
answer.
It's my fault. Like I'm trying to avoid... things that you say that annoy me, Zach, but then when I do that, it just goes on so much longer.
Yeah. I mean, let's put it this way. If you kept putting me off, I was just going to keep bringing it up, but if you answer it right away, I'm not going to ask it ever again. So, but, you know, it's pretty easy. to figure out the psychology of it all. How to go about it.
It's pretty easy to figure out how Zack operates.
Yeah.
I have the orders right there.
Alright, well, we succeeded on that very complicated quest. I think I'm done now. You are dismissed.
Fucking did it! I'm so proud of you.
Ah! Oh, let's see if our character's infamy and fame has improved.
Infamy, nope, you got it right.
It hasn't changed at all.
Nothing has improved.
I'm just gonna start mispronouncing words on purpose, Zach. Infamy.
What?
Infamy.
My name's Infamy Tammy.
You know, Mitzi, he says stuff like Iron, like instead of iron, and it just it really iron. Grinds my gears.
I say iron.
This is an interesting lover's quarrel.
It's obviously iron, but he just doesn't want to say it for whatever reason. And it makes me mad. It
makes you mad.
I'm gonna fucking kill him. Yeah, that escalated.
You kill him in his sleep.
I'm gonna...
This whole improv bit is just
I'm going to kill myself in a way where it looks like I was murdered, and then this will be video evidence that you were the one who did it.
Shit. I gotta go.
Wasn't there a movie like that?
What?
Wasn't there a movie where, like, somebody faked their death and, like, pinned it on somebody else?
Probably. That sounds like a movie that would exist, honestly.
I feel like that's a movie that exists somewhere in the world.
Yeah, it probably does.
You know what movie has to exist?
What?
Possibly?
Is that like a mafia?
Like, you know, instead of saying, like, oh, it could possibly happen, you know, there's a pasta detective that his catchphrase is, like, possibly. And he looks at the camera with a quirky Jim Halpert smile every time. And that goes on for, like, another 2 hours, you know?
Oh, hey, that's it's the you.
Possibly, and the film's called Possibly, of course.
Why does this guy believe me? Why does this guy fucking believe me?
He's an imposter.
I went up to the guy and said, "Hey, guess what? You're being transferred." And it's like, "What? I am?" But it's like, "What? I'm just some random person. Why does this guard trust me?"
Please, we're talking about Pasta. He should be a detective in New York City, so then he would have the accent.
Let me talk about the game every once in a while, damn it, Zach.
It's just a game.
You're a game.
And sports. It's in the game. As my...
I wish you would talk about the game more.
I like that we have conversations that aren't related to this game, but I also want to be able to say something about it occasionally. Just a reminder of what we're doing, what I'm doing.
You don't exist.
If I shared my screen, I will acknowledge that. If I can, I would like to try to like find a way to live stream these, just so you guys can watch what's actually happening on the screen. I don't have any that's like literally. I said this before, but that's literally the only reason I ever would live stream.
The only way I can think of doing that, like, because I don't know if you could download like full Twitch VODs, but like YouTube streaming on YouTube.
I would Twitch stream editing. I would do editing streams. I'd be down for that, but I don't really want to do gaming streams. But I would I would do it so you guys could see what I'm doing.
Well, like, YouTube is the thing is like the ideal way.
So we got rid of this guy's name who I cannot pronounce because I haven't heard how they pronounced it a single time because I hear you guys and not the game, but he's gone. You're cutting out. Fuck you.
Fuck you.
I have no more jobs for a thief of your skill. You have no need of the dog.
That's so beautiful. It was like a dance. Rumors that the gray fox himself
may call on you soon. Oh shit, I'm apparently so advanced that they are no longer going to give me jobs, but the gray fox is going to hit me up. When I'm in the cities, I have to keep my eye out for messengers from the gray fox. He could call me at any time. I should wait in the Imperial City if I want them to find me quickly. Alright, let's go to the Imperial City. How close am I to leveling up? Oh, I can go to bed and level up right now. Okay, we're gonna go to the Imperial City, get some rest at the waterfront, and then we're gonna fucking meet the Gray Fox, guys. That's gonna happen in this episode. You want me to send you a picture of the Gray Fox so you guys can see what he looks like? If you ever wanted to know what I look like, follow me on Twitter. What if the Gray Fox sounded like the top 15s guy?
I'd be for it.
I'll make him talk like that when I see him. Oh, hey, it's the guy I saved. I saved this guy's life.
Does he love you?
He actually, this is actually one of our...
Or does he hate you?
No, this is probably where one of the fames come from, because he says, like now I'm talking to him, he's being polite, and earlier he was saying, like, his life is in my hand. Like, he was very grateful because we actually saved his life.
You're one of the two people that actually enjoys your presence in this world.
And there's, like, a lot of fucking Thieves Guild people I talk to, so I think a lot of them are pretty two-faced. Okay, now 14 people hate us. Still two people like us. It's because we're in the Thieves Guild, and, like, there's no honor amongst thieves, so the other thieves don't like us, but there's also a lot of people we're stealing shit from, and they're like, hey, my cheese! So they hate us now. Just gonna sleep for an hour.
Daddy, he took my cheese.
Okay, so
sleep for an hour.
Let's put our personality up even higher. We're gonna make our speed better. Willpower and total fatigue. Let's put our agility up too. Yeah. Actually, our agility. You know, let's put our willpower up so we can get better magicka recovery.
In a world. Where New York is overrun with cheese, there's one man who can take on the job. Well, I can possibly do it. Bump, bump, bump. It's Pasta as a detective. What sorts of wacky things will this Pasta be into as a detective? Bump, 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 bump. Well, that's possibly the reason. Bump, 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 bump. And then he has, like, what sort of right-hand man sidekick could he have as a detective?
Luigi from the Mario Brothers.
Woohoo! It's just him.
The movie they put him in the movie without even asking Nintendo's permission. Then Nintendo are watching the movie, thinking, "What the fuck?"
And now suddenly Nintendo has to ask them if they can still put Luigi in their games.
They're just like, I just imagine someone at Nintendo, it's like, they're like, this movie made it into... How the fuck have they not been sued by us yet? What the fuck? Just like, because no one would ever be that blatant about it, like, because they'd be afraid of getting sued, but these people just had no fucking fear. They said, we're putting Luigi in our movie and we're not asking. And then the Nintendo's just like, I guess let's sue them. What the fuck? That's weird as shit.
Have you guys seen the Mario sex ed video?
Maybe?
You've been selected to learn firsthand about all the changes your body's been going through lately. Huh? Here's my brother Luigi now to tell you a whole heap of a spaghetti pile of information. Hello, Mario.
Send you guys the Mario sex ed video.
Alright.
It's a good video.
Alright, do I still sound the same?
Yeah.
Okay, maybe it'll work. I don't know. I tried switching my Wi-Fi.
I wanna know. Can you show me?
I wanna know about the strangers like me.
The Gray Fox is a task for you. Meet him at Helvius. Okay. Thank you, Meredith. That's what her name is, probably.
Himitsu?
What is this rich person doing here?
Do you want to sing Kiss from a Rose? Right now.
You guys got to do that in the recording.
I will record it right now. Hold on, let me...
We're not recording it right now.
We're at least going to sing it.
So, I'll do the instrumentals.
Yeah.
Okay, I do it.
No, I don't. I got the intro. I can't.
I got the lyrics on me.
Talking out of my ass.
We'll do line by line or verse
hold
by
on,
verse?
Hold on, I'm going to send you, hold on, first I'm going to send you the Mario sex ed.
Oh. Super Mario teaches safe sex. That's a thing?
Yes.
Cool.
I did not have... Okay, here's the thing. It is a real video. Like, it's a real thing that was created, but they don't actually have the licensings for these characters, and it was not created by Nintendo officially or anything. It was
Not even the voice actors are the same from the show?
No. It's just... It was like... Something like this... weird, like, obscure company made, like, back in the day.
Nintendo wasn't as big, so they didn't think it was gonna be like that.
Well, don't just tell him, Luigi! Show him! Luigi, what's that?
Alright, guys. It's time for our first encounter with the Gray Fox. I wanna do the voice for him, so shut up for a second. Please.
Okay.
Please. Thank you. Come, we must talk. I see you got my message. It's an honor to finally meet you. I have need for your special gifts. There is an item hidden away, remote monastery. I need you to go and get it for me. This monastery is extensive and well guarded, so you should make sure to be well prepared. Should you succeed, I will pay you well for your services. I would be honored to help. Capital. The monastery is called the Temple of the Ancestor Moths. It is where retired I will mark the location on your map. Look for it in the far northeast of Cyrodiil, beyond Shandel. I need you to acquire I imagine you talking like this while the stutter and everything. It is a large crystal of special. Remember, do not shed innocent blood. However, there is no blood price for slaying the stone's guardians, human or inhuman. When I receive word that Salvia's stone is missing, I will be here waiting for you.
Oh, wait, still
going. Okay. Shadow hide you. If you ever want to see what I look like, be sure to check out my Instagram.
Yes.
Why did you make me listen to that?
Yeah, why?
Because that's the Gray Fox's voice.
I don't like it.
That's the voice you decided to give him.
Yeah.
We need to talk. We need to discuss.
It's the Burger King foot lettuce voice. Hold on. Okay, I have to go there. Oh, wow. We're actually going to have to do... We haven't done this in the game yet, because we have been...
Honey, I would like to discuss marital status with you.
We are already divorced, Zach.
Honey, I would like to discuss marital status with you.
Absolutely not.
Honey.
Honey, you can get honey. You gotta get honey. If you don't, that means you just don't like fucking money. I'm gonna be condescending to you because you
I thought you were gonna be, like, doing the honey ad.
That's what I was doing.
Oh, it didn't sound like it.
It was the most, it's just the most condescending shit in existence. I'm not gonna get honey out of spite for Mr. Beast acting like a fucking asshole during those ads. Alright. 5,000 gold.
So, Mitzi, you got the lyrics or what?
I do have the... Why do you want this right now?
I don't know, why not?
Alright, you know, I could steal a horse. Sure.
Look, Mitzi, think about it like this. Mike only has the content that he just did. Like, do you really want the rest of the episode to be like this? Or should we provide content? He's not gonna help out. He's not gonna help out his own case.
I think it's funny that you out of the blue requested this. You're like, let's do karaoke right now.
We need to step up. What Mike just did. We can't let the show go on like this.
I just stole this woman's horse because they said it was going to cost 5,000 gold. So I just decided, hey, I'm a thief. I can just take it.
Now I have it.
You can just take whatever you want.
Yeah. I got a horse now.
Not my president.
Hmm.
Good thing I didn't vote for you.
Oh, anyway, yeah, that's give me, right. Give me a fucking intro. Tales give me an intro beat, Michael.
Again. We two were friends till the end. Ain't that's we, my friend? No. We kinda blend together.
That's not the song.
There used to be a great tower alone on the sea. You became the light on the dark side of me. Love remained a drug that's the high, not the pill.
But did you know that when it snows, my eyes become large and the light that you shine can't be seen?
Baby,
baby,
I convey it to a kiss
from a rose on a grave.
Ooh,
ooh, the stranger feels. Yeah. Yeah.
Now that your rose Where? Is in bloom,
bloom.
The light hits the
gloom. Right. And now this is where Mike does the bye yes.
Bye, yeah, yeah, yeah. I'll do it in the same voice I did for Grey Fox. Bye, yeah, 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 yeah. Bye, yeah, yeah.
Oh, it's so annoying. Okay. Who does this part?
I don't know. I feel like that was for you know, we'll do a full version in the Dungeons and Duckies episode. I feel like that was a good preview. That was very pleasant.
Good preview of what is to come.
That was very pleasant. I liked that very much. Good job, you guys.
Thank you.
Yeah, I aim to please, you know.
Back in the home country.
You actually singing is actually something you want to do more of, right, Mitzi?
Yeah, no, that's actually a goal of mine.
Yeah, because I can I can kind of tell like with the you got a nice little singing voice right there.
I'm sorry, you cut out.
I said you got a nice little singing voice right there. It's very nice.
Thank you.
Zach, yours, fucking of course.
12 years
yeah, it's
choir.
Kind of awful.
Yours was kind of up there with Freddie Mercury, to be honest.
Cool. Oh, yeah. You like the parts where I was, like, doing an accent for no reason?
I like the parts where it sounded like you weren't even singing a song.
Yeah, I like the part where I just went, like, gloom, you know? Like, pretty 10 out of 10.
I can't sing honestly. In tune at all.
I can't do notes that go on for too long. Like, if they're very short, I'm good. Like, baby! Like, I can't do that.
I can sing stupid fucking songs.
I want to sing, like, actual karaoke with you guys sometime. That would be so much fun.
That'd be fun.
I'd be down. That'd be a great thing to do if we, like, that'd be a
like IRL, like, go to a karaoke place.
Yeah, IRL.
I've never done that, but I would love to if it was with the right people.
We do, like, IRL karaoke together.
We gotta do Dungeons and Duckies IRL meetup.
Yes.
Fuck yes. You know what you guys should do? You guys should, we should get, like, a fucking, hotel room sometime up here. We should get for, like, a convention going on. It's like, there's a billion of, like, really good conventions that go on around here. And, like, we should definitely, and it's, like, a whole weekend that we should just, like, spend together and you guys can, like, meet my other cool friends.
Yeah, no, I'd definitely be down to do that eventually, and I feel like now it's, like, the drive always was intimidating to me, because it's gonna, no matter like where we meet up, it's gonna take a while for us to meet up. I think that the closest person to me is Austin, and it's still a 6-hour drive. But I mean, now I drive all day. I just feel like it'd be so easy to get through it.
I really, really badly want to do the next Dice Show Con since it got canceled this year, like a lot of other conventions.
What's that?
CinCon is in the Wisconsin Dells. It's in it's held in the Kalahari Resort. It's the Kalahari. It's held in the Kalahari Resort. It's really fun. They've got like a lot of the accommodations for the hotel are really fun, and so is like just the con in general. Like, there's a lot of conventions. I've been to a lot of conventions And God, I think I've been going to conventions for probably 13 years now, maybe more. Like, I would have to count my badges, but
I haven't been to a single one.
I was supposed to go to one in September. Actually, no, it was
fuck,
in
Matt's
May.
Here.
It was in May. And September.
So fucking sad.
I've never heard it. Finish what you're saying, sorry.
It was in May, and then it got delayed to September, and then they're like, we're just delaying it to next year, and you can get your money back if you want, and that was around the time I got laid off, so I'm like, yeah, I think I'm gonna get my money back.
My little sister, she was so upset when this happened, because it was the day before she was going to go see a Billie Eilish concert that everything started to shut down. It was a day before it.
Billie Eilish.
Yeah, Billie Eilish.
So what I was saying before is, like, there's a lot of conventions that go on around here in, like, the Midwest and shit, and DaishoCon is really nice because a lot of the conventions I go to, you have, like, your standard hotel and, like, convention area and stuff, like, but in the Kalahari, you have, like, an indoor theme park and, like, bowling, and you've got, like, several bars, including one of those, like, bars that's, like, attached to a pool, and, like, restaurants and shopping and stuff like that. So you have, like, all the accommodations of, like, this, like, really cool place. Oh, they also have a movie theater attached to it, so if you wanted to go see a movie while you were at the convention, you could do that too. It's basically, like, you got all these cool accommodations, and the water park, not to mention. So you've got all these cool accommodations that come with the Kalahari, plus just a really awesome convention with some, like, really awesome people and events and stuff like that. So I think if, like, I want to invite my friends to, like, come to any con, it's either that or Anime Milwaukee, and that's just because Anime Milwaukee holds a special place in my heart. But anyway, Matt, what I was talking about is, like, it would be cool if, like, we could get all, like, the Dungeons and Duckies crew together and stuff like that, and we could spend time at a con together.
I'll smash a bottle over Brent's head and, like, just bring him here unconscious.
Against his will. Just like God intended.
I hope you have found your stay here pleasant. Bye. Okay, bye, brother. I just found this cult, basically. And,
Aw, oh, sick. Nice.
Is this still Oblivion, or is this...
Yeah, it's Oblivion. It'll be Oblivion for a while.
Okay. Well, because I knew you were
doing
all, like,
whole,
playing...
Thieves Guild, thing. The whole storyline.
You were also playing, Persona.
That is, yeah, that's Stuart. Stuart's playing it. I've been in all the recordings of Stuart, but yeah, I haven't actually played the game once. Fuck off.
I don't keep up with your gaming videos that I'm not in.
What the fuck? How could you not want to watch an hour-long gaming video that you had nothing to do with? Piece
Look at
of
this
shit.
Guy.
Yeah, I'm disappointed that the horror con I was gonna do, it was Texas Frightmare Weekend, and they were gonna have Daphne Zanuga, who played Princess Vespa in Spaceballs, and they were also gonna have the director of Ginger Dead Man, Ginger Dead Man 2 and 3.
I've never gone to a convention. I've never attempted to go to a convention.
I have not been to a con either.
That was gonna be your first.
My first one.
I would definitely be down. I'd be down for it, but it's also not, like, something I've ever been, like, dying to do. I think the only time I really wanted to do it is when I was, like, a hardcore Rich Alvarez fanboy, and I saw him do conventions, and I was like, oh, I want to do that and make a video like he did. Because that looks so much fun,
It's a very weird experience going to a con for the first time, because you're like, oh, this is just not my crowd. But then the more you hang around them, you're like, oh, okay, this is actually kind of neat. I'm comfortable.
That is absolutely the opposite. Not exactly the opposite, but, like, when I went to my, like, first convention, I was so jazzed. It was literally, like, the most exciting time of my life. Like, even though I could only be there for, like, one day, because, like, I was, like, 13, I was so fucking excited about it. Like, I had, like, my cosplay on. I was, like, cosplaying with my friends, and, like, I met a bunch of other people who were, like, into the same stuff I was, and, like, there's a bunch of cool stuff for me to buy, and, like, you know, cool, just cool people to meet. And it was just, like, it was, like, all my crowd, because it was all just a bunch of, like, geeks and nerds and weebs and shit.
For me, I was just, like,
I feel comfortable and confident. It was, like, the first time in my life since, like, being a middle schooler that I was like, oh, I feel like a human being and not, like, trash.
I really like the web series that spawned Too Kawaii for Comfort.
Yeah.
And that's a show that you guys should absolutely check out sometime. It's very good. It's it shows off a lot of the, like, just true ugliness of something, like, something that, like, people, certain people you can meet at a convention can be like, but it's also, it's not just, like, shitting on it either. It's, like, it also shows a very positive side to it. It's actually a very, there's some very good meaning in the show. Oh, he's just making a run for it. There's some very meaningful things in the show, and it's very funny at the same time. But it's basically just about, like, five friends who go to a convention together, and something just immediately goes terribly wrong.
But, anyway, like, back what we were saying, like, for me, it was just, like, I was just more cautious.
Okay, I'm being, like, killed by three people.
It was, like, it was just, like, a new experience for me, so it was, like, I just didn't know, like, how comfortable I could be. I just needed to, like, absorb myself into the whole scene first before I had an idea of what I was getting myself into. You know.
I have been to like horror events, not conventions. It was just like, it was a marathon of movies. And that was fun because, like, it was, like, really interesting people there that I got to meet. And, you know, like, you're stuck between, like, the same handful of people watching the same movies. So after every movie, I was, like, talking with the people around me about the movies.
One of my favorite memories so far is seeing a guy at a panel dressed as Sailor Moon. Like, a guy who looks like he's in his 40s. Just did not pull off the getup.
Was it Aaron Hansen?
I don't know. Like, listen, you can be as confident as you want wearing something like that, that's fine. But, it was weird. It was. Not gonna lie.
I bet you pulled it off just fine, and your perspective's just skewed.
Yeah, that's, yeah, I guess so.
Listen, man, cosplay is all about having fun and being happy with yourself. And I think anybody can cosplay anyone that they want.
Yeah.
As long as you're not, like, trying to cosplay Hitler or something, you know.
I also agree that you can also look at someone and judge them if you want to.
I disagree. I think if you find yourself having judgmental thoughts, you should just whisk them away and try to learn and be a better person.
I know, but you're still allowed to have them. That makes us human.
I have never.
We can still grow from them, but, like, the instinctual, judgmental thoughts, like, they can still be there. That's very human to have. Not taking away human emotion, human thoughts away from that. Yeah.
I haven't worked on Halloween ever before this year. This Halloween was the first year I was working on Halloween. And I was at another store, because my store was closed, because one of my coworkers got the Rona, so we had to close until we got enough positive cases back, negative cases back, and I was negative, so my manager's like, hey, can you go over to this other store for me? And I'm like, alright, fine. And the manager over at the other store was at the Sailor Moon.
I don't fucking know. I've never seen I've just never seen any of it aside from on the internet.
I wanna bring you to a convention so bad. We would have so much fucking fun.
I'd definitely be down for it. Fuck, okay. Yeah, I can't fucking beat this when there's two people attacking me at once. I do not have... But, like, it's... This is tricky.
Are you
sucks, because, like, a bunch of the conventions I want to go to, and, like, especially, there was a couple of them that, like, I wanted to do, like, cosplay meetups for, like, really bad. Like, there's going to be an Adventure Zone cosplay meetup that I wanted to organize. And it was just like, well, nope, you can't do that. I'm like, this virus is taking everything from me.
Can coronavirus fuck off?
Come I'm sure on. After you said that, it'll listen. Yeah.
Like, I'm sure it will listen. Yes, the virus, we must plead with it. Has anybody tried bringing offerings?
Has anyone ever tried bringing cookies and milk?
Everyone who had the virus is, like, starting to heal up. And, like, by this time next week, there'll be, like, zero cases. Because I told the virus to fuck off.
Exactly. Matt is our savior, actually.
The virus is just like, wait, they don't like us?
Wait, they don't like me?
They don't like
me? I gotta go!
How could they not like me? Just trying to be their friend. What a bunch of assholes. I'm gonna stay.
What a bunch of penises.
Oh, man.
Oh, hey, Matt, I want to ask you a question.
Okay.
I'm really trying
not... Okay, if you had a dog that was the size of an ant, and...
Oh, not this again.
Would that dog be able to live comfortably in, like, a really, really big fish tank? Like, imagine, like, a super big fish tank, right? Do you think, like, if you, like, made it, like, a little habitat and stuff like that, it would be happy living in there?
We're talking about the German Shepherd-shaped, or
God damn it.
Ant-sized German Shepherd, right?
God fucking damn it. God fucking damn it.
That's what we do with, like, hamsters and mice and... Like, of course that would work for a dog. It's the same thing.
No, but would it be happy? It's not the same kind of environment that a dog would want. An ant wouldn't care, but a dog has different needs.
But what if you made it, like, what if you laid down some really small, like, you know, fake grass for it to run around on, and, like, mm-hmm. you gave it, like, toys and stuff like that? Like,
what kind of toys would you give for that size? What kind of toys would you give for that size of a dog?
You get little Polly Pocket toys?
That would crush it.
Wouldn't.
Yeah.
I think I know a little bit more
fucking
than
rat.
It'd be way too heavy for it. They'd be too heavy for it.
God fucking damn it.
You'd kill it.
You could make it toys. You could make it your own toys, like out of like paper and stuff like that too.
You know what you can't make it though? Other dog friends.
Well,
that would be
too bad I'm not the one who shrunk the dog.
I'm just saying, you're in this situation, you're gonna have to be creative here. It's your problem now.
What is the alternative, Zach?
There is none. This is the universe you're in, so what do you do?
But, like, plenty of dogs just, you know, live their lives domesticated,
I'm,
never interacting with other dogs.
You make it happy. All of its life, I make it happy. Happy dog.
You're fine. In a, like a hamster cage, because that's just what hamsters are. They're just tiny dogs.
Fuck. I may have severely fucked myself over.
Actually, I think that would be a better analogy for rats. Actually, rats can like learn similar tricks and things to that like dogs can. Rats are very intelligent creatures.
Oh, it's a skeleton.
Aw, rats.
Are you smarter than 5 gay rats?
Mm-mm. Mm-mm.
Oh, fuck. The monks are in here, too.
Not the monks.
Aw, them.
I'm actually in a really fucking bad situation right now.
Not ideal. Do not
sign
up. Oh,
fuck. Okay. Yep, there's spikes in the ground here. That's no good. How far back is this taking me? Probably last time I entered a room or before the autosave. Honestly, it takes me back before the autosave, before I waited.
You sound like you're having a good time.
Okay, you know what?
Having a grand old time.
Okay, I think it actually sent me back to a good place.
A good place, now on Netflix.
I think, unless I want to fucking cheat, I think I actually have hit a point where I need to turn around.
Turn around every now and then you get a little bit hungry.
I need better supplies. I need to be stronger. I need to train. I gotta quit the Thieves Guild missions for now, and I'm
turn
gonna go.
Turn around, right? And
thank you.
And I have the right snacks. I don't know the lyrics of that commercial.
Cause I am not ready for this. I'm gonna try to get better armor. I'm gonna try to get better weapons. Gonna do some more arena matches.
You need training montage. You know.
Mm-hmm.
You gotta train and sort of prove to the girl you love that you'd fight for her and stuff.
Right, let's go back to the arena. See how strong I've gotten in the arena. Still gotta kill that person who took 25 gold from me. That day is far, but it will come.
Come. Look at this guy saying the word come.
Oh. You remember when the very heartwarming Office finale made that joke?
No.
Dwight says, Michael, I can't believe you came. And then Michael says, that's what she said.
Remember The Office?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, how could you fucking forget about it?
You have this number one Office fan come out of the closet and be like, how could you? Like, just offended.
I'm actually tired of the fucking Office. I love that show. It's a good show. It is a good show. No disrespect, but it's just like, it is spammed everywhere. There are so many podcasts about it. It's on every single channel 24/7.
Every channel, including Cartoon Network and the Travel Channel.
Guys, did you hear that Rainn Wilson and Steve Carell were recently talking about a possible reboot for The Office? Did you know that it might come back?
I wouldn't be surprised. I mean, they might as well at this point.
The cast really like each other and they want to spend more time
with
each other.
That's whatever. That's fine. Like, they can do whatever they want. At this point, I feel like they might as well, because they're doing, like, all of them are spending all of their fucking time talking about The Office. They might as well just do it again.
Did you like it so much, why don't you marry it? And then they did.
that's what they call this show. So we did.
So we did.
The one of them married Emily Blunt and then made A Quiet Place.
Yeah. Oh yeah, that's right. A Quiet Place. I wasn't a fan of that movie, but it was it was not a poorly directed movie. It looks pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
I just don't like the. There's a lot of things I don't like about it. I wouldn't even say it's bad. I would just say that.
No, I agree.
I'd say it's mediocre. There's like some really not even mediocre as in the entire thing's okay. There's things about it that I really hate and things about it that I'm like, oh, that's actually pretty cool. It has positives and negatives. It's not just the entire time.
I agree.
Cool.
I agree.
I agree. There's a character named Else God Hater, and I came across in this game, Matt. And I went up to her and she said, I'm Else God Hater. That's right, I hate the gods. And then she went on about hating the gods for a bit.
E-I-R-L.
It did remind me of you. That's right. Okay.
advanced in rank.
I'm no longer pit dog. I'm a brawler. Now I'm in the arena, by the way. Brawler rank is... Ready for a match. All right, brawler. Here's the drill. Head up to that arena and show him who's boss. Another here's... Well, still alive, are we? Amazing. I never thought you'd make it past the first combatant. Just make sure you remember your place, brawler.
It sounds like you're rapping, but you're forgetting about the beat and the rhymes. You know, just how you're talking.
I'll just put them in some, like,
rap beat.
Sounds like
you're rapping, but isn't that just talking?
I'll just add the beats.
You know, it just sounds like he's, like, it sounds like he's doing a verse. No, it sounds like he's doing a verse, like, da 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 da. But there's like no.
Fucking Megalovania.
Yes.
You know who else sounds like they're rapping without a beat or rhymes? The fucking.
The dog from the Titanic film.
No, the Micro Machines guy.
Who?
Micro Machines guy?
Billy Mays here.
Yes.
I don't know what you're talking about either.
Please translate. We have the dumb.
Come on, it's like fucking making me not do anything. Jesus fucking Christ.
What's about to happen here?
Oh.
Don't put Rhythm Bot on!
Rhythm Bot,
what's his name?
Micro Machine. Or record it, okay. Alright, fine. If you're talking about this.
You're off the show. I'm sorry.
God fucking damn it.
That's the only one. That's the only one I'm gonna put.
That's not, I'm not even angry about that. I'm angry about what's happening in the game. I didn't fucking save again, and now I'm gonna fucking die.
This guy likes to talk fast. This guy talking fast. Like one of those talking fast people who like to talk fast.
God damn it.
One of those rap guys.
One of those people who rap.
Hey guys, can you tell me if men have skin or not?
Excuse you?
I need confirmation. Do men have skin?
No.
Yeah.
Males? Some do.
What?
So Michael doesn't have skin is what I'm hearing.
Mm-hmm. I donated my skin to science.
Skyance?
I'd say Skyance.
Usually your parents decide when you're born. If you're
he also doesn't have skin, but that's only in the Dungeons and Duckies canon.
Oh, what are we talking about here?
I don't know anymore.
I'm afraid.
God fucking damn it!
A friend of mine in another Discord what the fuck? Talking about... the fucking these like men's like body wash commercials where they're like men have skin too, and another friend of mine was like, do they? I was looking at you guys for confirmation.
Men have skin too. They're just like holding up signs that are very confused in protest.
Riots and fucking.
See, yeah. I was trying to make a circumcision joke and it did not land.
There's like sign pictures on their signs with like. The male body, but without the skin, so just like the bone and muscle.
I'm missing all of my skin except for my uncircumcised dick.
Yes.
That's the only skin I have left.
All I got.
Alright, fucking. Alright, fucking fine. You wanna hit? Hit, bitch.
Are you gambling?
Nope, I'm fighting, and someone else gambled on my death.
Sound like you were gambling, like, hit me, you know?
Have you ever gambled before, any of you?
For fun, in high school, I brought cards every day to school. High school, at least, maybe middle school as well. Like, whenever we have free time, we could just play blackjack or something, you know?
I'm always gambling, man. Life's a gamble. That's how it is. That's how it be.
I do not know how to play poker, though. Do not know.
I played poker, there was like two. My brother had like a poker night thing and I did join twice, but it's been like probably like 3 or 4 years since then.
Like, I don't understand, like, the numbers and, like, the math of it all.
I couldn't.
Like, you just need to get, like, 21 or, like, the highest amount close to 21, you know?
We did play Blackjack, too. I couldn't tell you how to play any of those games, though.
Yeah, I know Goldfish and Blackjack. I think that's it.
I know
I played Blackjack once, and I think I entered a fugue state while playing it because I do not remember what happened or how I played. Like, even in the... I cannot tell you how or what I was doing in the moment, but I somehow won.
Is there Blackjack online? That could be the new circle. If we can, like, play Blackjack and poker and stuff, that would be amazing.
There is, isn't there, like, a program that, like, you can download, like, a game you can download that's, like,
I don't want to download.
You play board games
and
crowd games, and it doesn't really, like, matter what it is. It's just, like, all-encompassing on that platform.
Well, I want a browser game that I can connect with friends with, that I don't have to download anything. Play Blackjack with friends.
Yeah, I have a winning poker strategy. As long as I'm playing with unconfident people.
Mobile phone.
I don't even think I'm gonna finish this fucking fight before the recording's up. God damn it, this is actually fucking annoying.
I don't find most gambling games to be entertaining.
Have
some
you
of them
any?
Are, but yes. I watch people play them, and I don't understand how they can be entertaining because it's like I don't know.
There,
it's like if I want to play a game, I'll play. What?
There was one or two Hanukkahs where
my fucking
favorite...
sword broke.
There was one or two Hanukkahs.
One game. Go ahead.
Thank you. There was one or two Hanukkahs where my family played dreidel. You know, like there's those four things, like whatever lands on you either get
that's
half.
That's the one with the song.
I played dreidel.
Because like one of the signs means you get like half of everyone's thing. One means you just pass one to the person left of you. One means you get everything. One means you don't get anything. You know. I think my grandma won. Once.
I'm being a big fucking cheater right now.
My grandfather is not Jewish, but he's like a weeb for Jewish culture.
A weeb for Jewish
culture. I don't like where the rest of this is going.
Well, he gave my brother and me and my cousin dreidel once, and we played dreidels with some chocolate coins.
I just cheated. I just lowered the difficulty all the way down and then won the fight.
How could you?
Because I was about to die and get sent back, and I didn't want to do that. And my sword broke, and I was fighting someone with my bare hands. I set it back to the normal difficulty now.
The one time I have played for real money, it was absurdly low stakes. It was, at a Boy Scout camp, at summer camp. We were just playing with, like, change. Literally, like, the buy-in was, like, a penny. There was a round where someone bet 2 cents and all of us folded. But I won enough to buy a soda from the soda machine, and I'm like, alright, I'm done.
Hey, y'all. I apologize for cheating, but there's something you should all know. This is all Zach's fault. Zach told me to do it. Zach was sending me messages throughout the entire exchange there at the end. So really, if you're going to be mad at anyone, be mad at Zach. You would not believe the messages he sent me about cheating before. You think what that dreams guy did was bad in Minecraft? You should see the ways Zach has cheated. It's disgusting. And he does it all the time, and he's probably doing it right now. What the